Yep, you're an idiot.
A defiant child who respects no one.
Mate, you don't swear at me. That's one thing you don't do. Do you understand?
Oh.
Do you understand?
This out-of-control 12-year-old is about to learn some serious, tough love.
No. Don't do it. Don't do it.
Bob Davis says, sadly, when it comes to disrespectful and abusive kids like Tyler, you really do have to be cruel to be kind.
Firm, but fair.
Tyler is so far off the rails, his parents are worried it could be too late to save him from a future life behind bars.
Tyler, give me the stick now.
He's angry and destructive. 4 months ago, Tyler's parents, Sean and Melissa, begged a current affair to help them find a way to help their son.
He's not the little boy you had.
No, not at all.
Former Special Services instructor Bob Davis hopes he has the answer. In this tough new environment, Tyler will be forced to follow rules.
It's yes sir or no sir.
And show respect whether or not he wants to.
We've just arrived at Tyler's family's home. His parents broke the news to him last night and say he took it pretty well. But at this point, Tyler believes he's only going to be away from home for a week.
He's about to spend a few weeks at the Hard Yakka bootcamp on Queensland's central coast.
Think it's the right decision for Tyler?
Definitely, yeah.
But behaviour specialist Tanya Curtis isn't so sure a bootcamp will bring about long-term change.
If a program is not addressing the original reasons for his behaviour, then it will have a band-aid effect.
This is where Tyler will spend the next 18 days. He'll have to be out of bed at 6:30 every morning and it's lights out at 9:15 at night. There's a daily roll call and military-style checks of the bedrooms every morning.
Miss Tyler, you gonna shake my hands, mate?
I'm not gonna tell
you. Not gonna shake my hands? No.
Maybe a few weeks.
Few? I thought it was a week.
He's furious.
I'm gonna stay for this long.
Who else is?
And he's letting everyone know.
You got any comments on that so far?
Yep, you're an idiot.
You don't swear at me because then I can do it back to you.
Good. Off.
Sit down.
Leave me.
Tyler remains defiant.
Mate, I want you to settle down. All right, now settle down.
No, leave me the alone.
Watching her son's angry outburst in front of strangers is too hard for Melissa.
But it was good for them to see straight out what we're going through.
Bob is still trying to calm his new recruit.
You're really upset, aren't you?
But Tyler refuses to surrender.
I'm a scum dog. Get out of my face.
And lashes out.
Don't touch me! Don't touch me!
Tyler is clearly distraught but continues to fight.
Boy, why are you like this, mate?
Let go!
You let go and say please.
No!
Don't try anything. You're not going to win, mate. No.
Camp mentor Mark Fuller has seen it all before. He works in the prison system.
If they stay on that road, they generally end up in juvenile prison or an adult prison, which is what I'm trying to get them to avoid doing.
You gonna stop?
Yes! Let go!
Please!
Please!
Tyler is finally giving in.
You get up.
Mum and Dad.
I don't care.
Bob believes his tough love approach changes the lives of wayward youths like Tyler.
What we do, we know works, but we certainly don't step over that line to the point where the young person is physically hurt.
The boys live rough. They sleep in shipping containers with basic bunk beds and thin mattresses. It teaches them appreciation and respect.
Tyler came with his iPhone. Can he keep that?
No.
No phone?
No.
No iPod?
No.
I can't go no higher!
You can
doing good, mate. Keep going.
No, I'm not doing it.
Keep going.
Yes, Tyler, come on.
This camp for at-risk young people is challenging Tyler to do things he doesn't believe he's capable of.
Let me know when you're ready to go,
mate.
I'm
ready.
All right, go for it, mate. Come on, do it. Yeah!
The activities help boost true confidence and self-esteem.
See that? You just completed that. Good job, mate. Good job.
We set them up to achieve so they can feel good about themselves.
Well, Bob just said he's really, really happy with his progress.
It's graduation day and time for anxious parents from across Australia to see how Hard Yakka has influenced their troubled sons.
My name is Tyler, Chief in Operation Hard Yakka, and I'm Chief in Life, sir.
Sean believes him and couldn't be more proud.
What do you think, Sean?
Amazing. What a long way he's come.
He can't wait to congratulate him.
Hey, buddy, how are you?
In stark contrast to day one, Tyler is smiling and upbeat.
Enjoying it?
Yeah.
Yeah? Oh, that's great, mate. It's good to see you anyway, mate.
Missed you heaps.
The real respect started coming, I believe, when he knew that we were there to help him. Tyler certainly was outspoken to a point where it was really pronounced.
What do you think you'll do differently then?
Just not knowing off, behave myself.
Bob is quietly confident Tyler and his fellow boot camp graduates now have a chance for a better life.
These kids are important. They really are important. Sorry. And we can't let these kids get any to that level where, you know, they can't be saved. I didn't know I was gone.